Our pasta is falling apart. This is a whole ass mess.
We decided we're gonna make lasagna.
I wanna do like a green.
Okay, good, good, good. We got the herbs. You know what I mean?
We're hoping that this turns out amazing and perfect the first time.
I'm excited! I love what is happening.
This is gorgeous.
So,
are we on?
We're always on, Andy. Okay, so here we are with Andy.
In sunny California.
At my house. This is the first time Andy's ever been here. And I invited Andy over to cook with me today. But we didn't really do any planning. We decided we're gonna make lasagna.
We know that, but we also know like each other's flavors.
Yeah.
Riff.
We're gonna riff and then I'm gonna turn it into a recipe eventually. Like, I will like test it. But if it's not good, we won't turn it into a recipe.
Yeah. Thank God. I'm always in need of a cabana bow. Starting with lasagna.
Yeah.
Where do you wanna start?
Well, one thing that we did this morning, or not this morning, that we did last week, was I had Andy send me a list of like the most Andy ingredients ever to make sure that I just like have his pantry on lock. Here are the top 11 most Andy ingredients ever.
There's probably more, but.
1, vinegar. 2, citrus. 3, yogurt. 4, spices. 5, nuts and seeds. 6, dried ground chilies. 7, fresh herbs. 8, scallions and shallots. That's 2 ingredients. Alliums.
Oniony things, just oniony things.
9, olive oil. 10, tomato paste. 11, miso. Should I make my list really quick? Here, will you hold? I put 11. 1, dill. 2, sesame seeds. 3, lemons. 4, mortadella. 5, fresh chilies. 6, alliums. 7, pistachios.
Okay.
8, anchovies. 9, sesame oil. 10, sour cream. 11, parmigiano reggiano. Okay.
Should we shop?
Yeah.
Let's go get in the car.
Are we like in a lasagna renaissance of sorts?
It feels like lasagna. It's like everybody's breaking the rules with lasagna right now.
It's not like red sauce and white sauce. It's like red, white, green, brown. Okay. I feel like I kind of want to do like a green sauce.
Okay, good, good, good. please don't say red or white.
No, 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 for a few reasons. A red sauce, it's like, I just feel like if you do a red sauce, you really have to like cook.
It's gonna take hours.
You're gonna, even if there's no meat, it's like you do kind of want to cook the canned tomatoes out a bit before you start assembling.
Okay, so just mix of cheeses?
Mix of cheeses and like a shit ton of cream.
Because the other thing I was like, I've never had a, but could be into, a potato lasagna.
Oh my God.
Like if we like mash up fresh lasagna with like a shingled potato gratin.
Yeah.
And incorporate like green into it.
Carbs on carbs.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like kind of in the vein of like, you know, like potato topped focaccia.
Okay.
Isn't that fun?
That feels right. Okay, so we have a green sauce.
Yeah.
Potatoes, pasta.
Cheese, parm, obviously.
Parm, I think, without a doubt. I think not just on top, I think it could easily be integrated throughout. I do like fontina in a lasagna.
I do too. So if we've got our like milky creamy moment happening with the cream, then let's go like harder on the cheese in terms of like its personality.
To make the green sauce though, I think we should, we're not making a pesto, but I think like incorporated, I would say a few herbs in the cream. Like I think we could blend it. Basil, parsley, dill would be good. Season that, like salt, pepper, tons of lemon zest.
Yeah.
And make it like herby, lemony, and fatty.
Yeah.
And then it's like.
Part of me is like, what can
more
we
black
do?
Pepper.
Yeah, but what else can we do on that like top sheet that's just gonna like send it over the top? Like,
so I was thinking this.
Or a thing.
And it's like a little annoying, but if we like, for like the interior of the lasagna, we do like, you know, 1/4 inch thick slice of potatoes, but on top it's like super, super thin.
Oh, so there's potato chips on top. I love that idea. Okay. And maybe that's where rosemary comes in, like on the
scattered
top.
Something.
Scatter potatoes, more thinly sliced potatoes and rosemary. And then we'll drench it in cream.
This sounds great.
It's gonna be so good. I'm obsessed with it already.
Yeah, the potato, like mortadella crispiness on top.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Really?
It's also thicker than I thought, so.
Which is actually good.
It's so funny. I don't think we've ever done a collab recipe ever, like even back in the day.
No.
She's also taller because she's wearing shoes. Let's like make sure.
He's
like,
on his tippy toes.
I just went on my tippy toes. I just went on my tippy toes.
Do you want to put your shoes on?
It's fine.
Do you want me to take mine off?
Okay, that's there. I was gonna be good. Mm-hmm. We need that.
Mm-hmm.
We need
otherwise
like,
it's gonna be bland.
Yeah, we need a dairy that has like a lot of oomph.
Calm down. Okay, so you're using 4 ounces of shallots.
Yeah, I wrote it down.
Oh my god.
Ah! We're using Yukon Gold.
Yep. What do you think, this many inside or more? I think more.
I think, what is that, like?
6 of them.
So we're doing two pounds. Okay.
That feels good. And then plus one more for the top?
Yes.
So we're gonna cut the sheets into this size and then leave one big and like do like a
crimpled situation.
Yeah.
Tin this into water.
So they don't
discolor.
Yep. And then we can even use that same water and put ice in it for blanching
the. Blanching the.
Yeah. Okay, so I want to talk to you about the thickness.
The thickness? Okay, let's see. That feels pretty good right there.
Right?
Yeah, that feels good.
Okay.
Wow.
Like, look at this already. That's only 2 potatoes.
Oh, okay. We're gonna have to adjust. No, this is trial and error though. It's
no,
like
this is
and
how
like
you
we're catching
recipe.
It. And this is this is how you test a recipe out. But luckily like we know we can make that change beforehand. Because I don't think we're gonna need more than maybe We have 3 pounds, a little over 3 pounds of pasta. We are not gonna use even 2 pounds of pasta, I feel.
This is how you develop recipes, right? Like you write notes. I'm doing this because it feels like in the spirit of you, but like this is not how I normally do it.
Well, I'll say this. Well, Chris Morocco was very much this. This was like the
chicken scratch.
I definitely would type a little bit of a template and then I'd add all my notes.
That's how I would do it.
I need like a little bit of
this. But I feel like it's annoying to have our computers right now.
That's true.
Okay, and then I'm doing thinner ones for the top, Andy, right? We think. Mm. Like even thinner than this.
Yeah. I don't think it's, I think it's like an 1/8 inch situation.
Okay. Put these in a separate bowl. So we've got potatoes one way, potatoes two ways. This is, okay, so 8 ounces set aside. They're all gonna get submerged in water. All great cheese.
Okay.
This really is the perfect kind of recipe for 2 people to tackle.
It didn't take us long to think like, oh, we should do lasagna.
No, we just knew. I feel really happy that you said, let's go fontina. I just want to.
Yeah, of course. I mean, when it comes to cheese world, even though I don't use cheese all the time, when I'm gonna use a cheese, like I want it to be a good cheese.
Yeah.
Question, lasagna world. Are we using rosemary in this dish?
We.
So then I'm gonna put it in this cream sauce right now and infuse it.
Okay.
Right, that feels right.
Okay. One large sprig. Correct?
Yes, perfect.
This is
I'm gonna just bruise
kind
it a
of like
bit.
Thanksgiving-y.
It is.
Lasagna.
It's definitely like a fall winter lasagna.
Right?
Because I don't think of lasagna as like I understand it's like heavier and people eat it when it's colder, but like I'll have lasagna in the summer. So right now it's like we're really doing, the sauce takes very little work as of now. It's like we're using not all, but like 1/3 of the cream. And
how much did you put in there?
1/3, I still have half left. One large sprig of rosemary, 2 large shallots, and like 8 cloves of garlic, and just like crushed whole, they're all gonna get soft in the cream. We're just going for like very, very, very soft garlic and shallots. And like,
are you gonna simmer it or are you gonna bring it up and steep?
I'm gonna simmer it because I want it soft. I don't want to bite.
Okay, so I will blanch pasta. You already seasoned? No, we talked about
seasoned?
This.
No, not yet. Okay, I'm going very light.
I love that you're peppering the pan.
Oh yeah.
Step one, pepper the pan.
Okay, so we have our dish prepared.
We need to cut these to size.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that'll fit.
Oh, that's good, perfect.
I am loving this pasta dough.
I do too, it's so eggy.
Yeah, and supple. This honestly is maybe too supple.
I know, it's like,
did they not
very
like-
very soft. I feel like they didn't
work the dough.
Work
or like
the dough.
Fun! Mmm, smells good over here. I feel good about the fact that you're simmering.
Mm, that smells like
Thanksgiving.
Yeah, I'm telling you, this is the Thanksgiving.
One thing to note, these are small shallots. They're gonna take less time than a large shallot.
But we can chop them?
But you can always chop them. Pasta?
Oof.
Ooh. So delicate.
I think we should dump.
Dump.
Uh-oh. Our pasta's falling apart.
Pasta's breaking.
Okay.
Yeah, like big
time. You might need to hold it like this.
Surgery.
Perfect. Hopefully people get pasta that does not break at home. And if it does break, I think we're gonna prove that it doesn't matter.